All right, ladies and gentlemen, you guys actually told me to come to Modern Warfare 3, go to the private matches, and then select to add bots. And then you're going to add the bots. I guess we can have six, and you're going to set them to veteran, apparently. And then we hit confirm. Make sure we have teammates. We get five. Set them also to veteran. Apparently, when we get into the game, these bots will be level... one of the 250 calling card people, and they'll be wearing skins. Let's see if this is true. Right there, I didn't see any skins, so I don't know. Why are my hands so tiny? Apparently, we have to watch the kill cam. Oh, look at that! They're wearing skins! Oh my god, this is disgusting. Even in our non game mode. So now the next part of this theory is we have to die and watch the kill cam. We gotta get killed. We'd have to find a teammate or an enemy. There's one. Hey, let's see what the kill cam is. It says it apparently is 200. They are top 250. So how can you tell between the bots and the non-bots anymore? That's exactly what I see in my games all the time anyway. That's disgusting. We have bots inside private matches. We have skins inside private matches now. Look at that. That's disgusting. Where'd all the bots? Skin wear. So you can't even get away from it in your own private matches. No matter what, you're going to see skins, so you have to buy the game. Or to buy the bundles. Disgusting. Alright shorties, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host Shorty Index, and we're going to be playing some TDM on Favela. It's a 21-21 gameplay that I told you about earlier in the week. We're going to start off this video by saying thank you to Ty Beats for letting us know in the comment section down below that there is skins inside of the actual private lobbies. I read all your guys' comments and I check out everything you guys say, and if I think it's warranted, I'll make a video on it. So I appreciate that, Ty Beats. So here's the problem. What is the problem with having skins inside of the private matches? Well, the problem is that the bots that we're running into inside of the actual game seem to be moving and looking a lot similar to the people that we just saw inside of that beginning intro clip. And the fact that they're wearing bots in the private matches only goes to amplify the fact that there could be legitimately real-life bots being put inside the game. I can't say with certainty because Activision has been dead silent on the whole bot front, but it does seem like that. But I can say from a player standpoint, it really freaking pisses me off that there's skins inside of my private matches. I'm already a player that kind of hates the skins because it really, really breaks immersion. If they were all like combat skins and you were just paying for like different urban camos, the Canadian camos and the American camos and the Swedish camos, but you still look like a normal soldier, I'd be completely fine with that. But even in that opening intro clip, you saw there was like a Spartan wearing bright blue Athena capes and stuff like that. Come on. That's immersion breaking, and it absolutely destroys my faith in humanity when I see people wearing that. But the real issue with having bots inside of your private matches is the fact that you cannot tell the difference between those players and the players that we're accusing of being bots inside of the actual game. With Activision being deadly silent, it's kind of led way to being an absolute conspiracy theory. But here's the thing, every conspiracy theory's got a grain of truth to it. We do know that this Corona script bots for reverse boosting accounts already in the game. We know people are using scripts to not get kicked when they're AFK while they reverse boost at home. So there most definitely is bots in the game. Whether or not Activision's in on it, that's a whole different story. And let's be real, up until a month ago, even though everybody knew that there was skill-based matchmaking in the game, they adamantly denied the fact that skill-based matchmaking was in the game. And then they finally admitted it, but only once the controversy around bots inside of the game started to arise. So they decided to throw us a biscuit and a little distraction with, hey, skill-based matchmaking exists, which came to a surprise to none of us. But now, with the proof of there being actual bots wearing skins inside of our gameplay set to veteran difficulty, it seems very similar to the gameplays that we see of people saying, hey, these are bots in my lobbies. And it really kind of pisses me off. Here's the thing, if I have to play devil's advocate and there is going to be bots inside of my game, I'd rather those bots not be walking billboards for a commercial to advertise me to go to the item store to buy a skin. I'd rather me know that I'm fighting a bot. Nobody wins in a bot-filled lobby. No one. If you do good and you're fighting a bunch of bots, then you beat a bunch of bots. You still did bad in the eyes of the average person. And if you lose to a bunch of bots, well then you did even worse because you lost to a bunch of bots. But in Call of Duty, they're setting it so the bots are basically walking commercials. Now, like I said, I'm going to be your conspiracy theorist here, and I'm going to say that imagine in a couple years you're going to be playing games, and every fifth game you got to play a bot lobby because of the fact that they need to advertise skins because you haven't bought a skin in a while. And you're not allowed to quit. Don't say they won't do it, because EA already put commercials inside of NBA games. UFC's already done commercials around the entire ring. with paid advertisement spots, just like in real life. So you're telling me that Call of Duty won't do that? Pretty soon we're going to be playing on maps called Billboard, and we're just playing in like Times Square with nothing but absolute ads going all around, and they're actually current ads for real life things. Callouts will be the Coca-Cola sign. Yo, go get the guy underneath the Ford Raptor tunnel. Don't tell me that's not going to be the way it is, because it's starting to really feel like in Call of Duty we're playing in a dystopian future. You have the Overlord AI bot that's evilly sitting in the back ready to ban you and hit your social credit score at any given moment for saying anything that goes against anything that the bot decides and deems is not worthy of it. You also have the constant state of SBMM rigging your matches so you go against people that are the exact same as you, carbon copies, almost like we've been cloned and we have to fight against ourselves. You have EOMM, manipulating matches halfway through to make sure that nobody gets their feelings hurt and everybody feels the exact same. So, because if everybody feels the exact same, then everybody's happy and everybody will just continue to play the game. All based off of a computer program ran by the same AI bot that's listening to us. So do not think it'll be far-fetched for Call of Duty to start making us play on advertisements. Before every match, we gotta watch a commercial. You can't even go play private matches against bots without having to have a constant reminder that there's an item store in this game. I hate the item store. I hate the item store in every single game that has ever existed. Here's the thing. There's always that person that says if you don't like the item store, then don't buy it. I don't. But I shouldn't have to be reminded every 5 seconds about it. But I want to delve a little bit deeper. I want to break this down a little bit more. And I want to make it real nice and simple for the absolute idiots who enjoy the fact that there's an item store in every single game that you buy. Every single thing that they sell you, every single item, every single skin, every single character is content that they took out of the game to sell you later. You absolute peon. Think about it. All the cool animated skins are now locked behind a paywall. That's all content that you no longer get in your base game, where every other COD up until Modern Warfare 2019 had that content in the game. Skins and stuff in the item store used to be a secondary to the actual game. It was play the game, make a good game, and people will buy the skins after. Fortnite proved that. The game was good, and then they added skins later, and people bought those skins. Because also, Fortnite was a free-to-play game. Now, Call of Duty charges you $70 up front to give you a subpar game and then adds an item store where everything in that item store costs half the actual value of the game. Inside the game, there's like, what, 100 million operators? And each one has its own skin, but that skin can't be used on another operator. No, you gotta buy a separate skin for that operator. And the same thing for guns. Every gun has its own skin, but you can't use the camos on each skin. No, you gotta go buy another skin for that gun. They have monetized the living crap out of this premium price game. At this point, give us Call of Duty for free. I can't even go into my private matches and not see a bunch of bots running around wearing skins. It makes me want to vomit. It makes me sick to my stomach. It makes me so sad to see the state of where gaming has come. It makes me even sadder that there's people out there that truly enjoy this dystopian future that they're setting up for themselves. Hey man, when Call of Duty eventually makes you watch commercials in order to get kills or bullets or stuff like that, or you have to pay a certain amount of money per freaking goddamn time you want to load your magazine, don't come crying back to the Call of Duty channels that told you about it. Oh, don't say they won't do it, because they've already added timer cooldowns inside of Zombies. Remember, Zombies is a premium game mode that's completely tied to the Call of Duty franchise, yet now you can pay for boosters that allow you to get your timer cooldown down faster. Remind you of any other game? Oh yeah, every mobile game ever that has ever existed ever has the same kind of concept. Remember Clash of Clans? You wanted to build a new archery tower? Well, you had to wait 2 days. You can now do that in Zombies, your premium paid DLC game. The state of microtransactions inside of Call of Duty, inside of pretty much every game ever now, is pretty sad. These developers spend more time developing things to sell you than actually developing of the game. Think about it. Call of Duty has remastered a bunch of maps from Modern Warfare 2, sold it to you in a game titled Modern Warfare 3, and each one of those maps plays poorly because they didn't even take the time to make the spawn mechanics work for the newer age games and the newer age players. So they save money by remastering the old maps, which, let's be honest, they probably already had done for the Modern Warfare 2 as a DLC add-on for one of the seasons there, but decided to sell it to you as a full price game. What the hell do you think they were doing for the year of the Modern Warfare 2 lifecycle? Making these maps. They then save money by selling you a Warzone campaign, being able to use Warzone POIs in order to make you, the little rat you are, run around and feel like you got some content. They then made you feel like you had extra content in the game by transferring over everything from Modern Warfare 2 into Modern Warfare 3, so you actually feel like the game's super full, but it's actually really not. Then they save more money by just reusing the same guns and making you unlock them twice, but with a slightly different name. And all of that while they were continually making skins for both Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 2019, Cold War, and every Call of Duty for the last 5 years has gotten a continuous stream of skins. Yet we can barely get them to address spawn points, match balancing, gun balancing, or even the fact that the game is very poorly optimized. And now, you can't even go into a private match, sit there with your friends, and not have to verse a bunch of bots running around with skins. I want to be honest with you. The bots are just a catalyst to my anger. The skins on the bots are also a catalyst to my anger. It's a combination of everything that is just so blatantly wrong with Call of Duty, adding up over time. SBMM plus EOMM, plus all the other match manipulation tactics, AI bots listening to us, plus all this constant skins, breaking the immersion. This all adds up into a very overly frustrating game. This is a military simulation shooter. Yes, it's an arcade shooter, but it was meant to be based in realism, or at least that was the argument in Modern Warfare 2019 when they slowed down the game. And it was the same argument from all the people that hated the fact that the game was so slow. The people that loved the game being slow said, oh, it's so real now. It's more realistic. Those same idiots are the same people buying fluorescent pink Power Rangers costumes to run around the map and laser bullets to turn you into pixels. Every goddamn map feels like I'm playing inside of a kitten fluff ball that's intending the pixie dust masquerade. I feel like I'm in cotton candy wonderland with demons. The game isn't realism, the game has no soul, the game has no direction, the game has lost its way. At this point, Call of Duty needs a complete reset, right back to basics. Not meaning like, rip boots on the ground. I'm meaning straight up right back to basics. Rip everything out and go right back to the original COD 4. Simple guns, simple skins, simple maps. Everything can be earned, nothing can be bought.
But Jordy, they need to have the items to be sold to you so they can continue development.
Oh, I forgot how games fucking worked for the last 30 years before Call of Duty had all these skins. It's almost like they had to release the game and keep the game running in order for players to stay there, and that's how they did it for years. God, I hate the arguments. They're so freaking simple all the time. Game developers lasted years without having to constantly upgrade the item store for them to have constant rotation of their merchandise and to be able to maintain development of the game. They pay the developers less than ever, while CEOs take the biggest bonuses ever. And this private match proves that they don't give a crap about us. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I've been your host, Jordy Index, and this is the end of my very angry rant. I'm trying to tone it back a little bit because monetization on YouTube doesn't like it when I get super angry, but I'm starting to get ready to pop off again. If you guys enjoy the content, please hit that like button. Do not forget to subscribe, and as always, leave a comment down below. Clearly, I read them. And I hope you guys have a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Have an amazing day, everyone. You deserve it.